Hi guys, how are you doing? For the past video, maybe you have seen a lot of the success story and also the tips and all this how to do the gardening. But what is behind scenes sometimes, that's not what you think. There are a lot of the garden failure is going and a lot of challenging is going for you to improve yourself and challenge yourself all the time. Today, I would like to share with you about this problem that I have. Okay, today what we're gonna talk about is that what might be the cause of certain problems that occur into your garden and also how to identify it. I grow this bitter gourd is only by accidentally. I would like to say that because this plot of the bitter gourd, what happened is that when I preparing the soil to measure the soil and then I mix some of the decomposed kitchen waste and all the weed and other things inside and the compost from the animals and all this type of thing. So when I mix it inside, and I supposed to leave it there for about 2 months for the soil to be ready to use in my garden. I'm doing all this preparation because I really want to make sure that my soil and everything from the start is really a purely organic. With the time come, I noticed that there is a bitter gourd, a small plant is coming up from that. So it could be from the seed that is left over and then it happened to grow. So I don't want to waste it. So what I did is I took the risk and then I dig up, I relocated it into this plot. I would like to think back about on how we're doing it because actually this type of a very thin and fine leaves here, they don't like to be relocated. They get very easily get very upset and then they intend to not doing well. But however, I manage. I can share with you a little bit on the tips on that also actually. So what did I do is that after I prepare the soil for the plot and I dig up the hole, I have this formula. It's a very good fertilizer that is I'm making from beans. And it's a very high nitrogen and some can even say that equal to urea fertilizer. So what happening is that I'm using that in a very small quantity, put it under, and use the soil to cover up a little bit, preventing the root from here that is a very young plant at that point of time to directly hit into the it will be too strong. So after I grow it already, I prevent it from the direct sunlight by cover with something. I'm using just the very fine palm leaf to cover it up. And then on top of the soil, I put a lot of the weed to cover the soil again. That way it preventing the water to come out to get the heat up by the sun and then it will dry up the soil faster. So I just cover and after that I make sure I water twice a day. The soil is always moist and so the result is I've been taking care of it too good that every plant here survive. So when it all survive, the number of plants is too many. And that is also my problem, okay? So I would like to share with you that first of all, the structure for this plot is totally wrong because with the number of the plants that is quite, all of them are survive and it's a lot. So you should have the taller structure or even a turner. So these plants, they need a lot of sunlight. They need full sun. And every rib should be spread out all evenly. From there, they will be able to find more food and they can have more flower, they can have healthier plants and then more fruits for you. But because of the leaf now is layered, overlapped. So this is one of the problem because it will weak the plants. And then you will see that the flower is lesser, but the flower lesser is not always because of not enough sunlight also actually, it's also because of the diseases. Now, I would like to tell you the first thing first, where is this disease can happen? What is the cause? It can come from the soil, but from the soil, I have a treatment before I turn over in every vegetable, so I'm quite safe that. Second is could come from the seed of the mother plants. Oh, for this area, how to prevent? Normally, you need to get the seed from your reliable distributor, actually, okay? So from there, they make sure that the seed, they don't come with the disease because if the mother plants having the disease, the seed that you're collecting and grow, also there's a chance for you to having heritage as well. So the next problem that might have is that is from the condition of growing. Like this, the plant is will be too weak because a certain layer and inside they might not be able to get a good sunlight, and that also make the plant too weak and they can have disease very easily. The next factor could be the weather. I noticed that this is starting off is very fine. Okay, so until about more than a week ago that I noticed some of the problem, but I ignoring it. And now the problem getting very bad, but not is that until the extent that I have to clear off everything. So the weather is very hot in daytime, and in the evening normally will have the rain. So this type of thing is very dangerous. Some people say you don't water your plant in the evening. Okay, there is certain reason why you should not water the plants too late in the evening. If the water throughout the day, the weather is too hot and the place is too dry. So there is certain thing you need to avoid. The plants can be stronger and more better immune for the resistance on the diseases that might coming in along because of the weather. Lastly, is because of the insect. This is the main factor. So how to prevent actually the insect? You can do a few things. If you're seeing the insect, you try to keep the treatment, or you have to do the weeding. Because the weed and all this that is under, you try to make it very neat and clean and clear, because that is a playground for all the insects and they breed from there. So from here, I would like to move on to the next thing, is how to identify the problem. It's very easy. If you can notice that this is the two different of the problem here. One is the burning leaves. This is a burning. They will shrink, curl up, and then have the burning, and then the young shoot coming out. The leaf will getting smaller. Okay, this is a problem that we having here. And another problem that we have is that the leaves itself, they will started to have the dot, like yellowish dot like that. And after that, there will be the hole. So that is also another types of the problem that I can see from this plot. This is a two problem that I have. It's a two totally different. See this? This is a burning, like the leaves is a burning one. So this is one of the types that we having here is a disease. Another types is, okay, we got it. Okay. This one, you can see that the leaves is turning a little bit of yellow spot by a spot like that, and then it will be lubang at the hole as a later stage. So this one, usually it can happen to a lot of vegetable like a cucumber, like a lady finger and all this. You can see a lot of hole over there. So what you should check is have to check from the back also whether that is a insect or not. Okay, most probably will have, but so far here I don't see any, but if I search carefully, definitely I see a lot of it. But the problem is not that so severe, because I would like to notify you that the stem is still very fat and healthy. Like all this, you can see that they are okay. So it's worth to save it. It's not until that it shrink down, it's small, skinny, it's not like that. This is still very, very healthy. Okay, and there's still got a lot of fruits and also the flower. So it worth to save it. This is very good for your kitchen, because my kids like this, they are having the bearing the good fruits. You can see here, the fruit is still very nice and good. Okay, so all these things is still bearing fruit, bearing the flower very well. All you need to do is taking care of it. Maybe you need to spray with the organic formula for one or twice a week until you can see the improvement. I might not be able to turn this leaf that is to be a better condition now, because this is already happened. This is a waste. But I will make sure the young shoot and the new leaf that is coming up here is going to be a healthy one and is a better one. And this is the age of it that is coming into bearing the fruit stage. So I have to make sure that it's having a good fruit and a good yield in the future. Okay, so what we're gonna do about this, there will be the next episode, because I have the formula. That this formula is very good for the treatment for all this problem. You just need to mix with the water, spray it on the top and the under. So I don't want to keep rowing on this episode so much. We are knowing very well on how, why the disease is happening and what are the causes. And then also we can identify the disease on how is it look like. So this is a common problem. So what we're gonna do is the next episode, I'm gonna show you on the formula that we having, and it's very effective, can be DIY, is all the local materials that it can turn out to be something so useful for all type of plants that have might have the similarity of the problem. Okay, so thank you for today, and I will be seeing you again next week. Hope you enjoy the video, and if you are a vegetable grower, you encounter this type of the problem, PM me or put the comment below, and then I might be able to help you. Okay, thank you so much. Bye.